"If you plan to fire a ball tight," said James wickedly, "I should spin them round and aim them into the hallway." Cheney's familiar smell filled Harry's nostrils. Old polished wood gleamed on the walls and floors. The welcoming fire blazed in the great open grate in the hallway. The last of the light was going, and by the lanterns illuminating either side of the door, he looked up at his father's dominating portrait. The Admiral was in full dress, resplendent in a mass of gold lace and sparkling decorations, with the red sash of the Order of the Bath across his snow-white waistcoat. James had painted it while still quite young. Harry could never look at it without wondering what his father had said when it was unveiled, but James had put a 100-gun ship under full sail with a vice-admiral's pennant atop the mainmast. That flag, the insignia of his father's command, and the other flags streamed backwards from the masts. The admiral would have spotted the error as quickly as Harry, for they should, of course, have been streaming towards the bows. Had he said anything? Harry never had. It seemed churlish, for James had caught his father well. His brother was a devotee of Alan Ramsay, who seemed to escape his general condemnation of things Scottish. He agreed with Ramsay that a portrait painter had a duty to see beyond the mere face, a duty to look for an expression that would give some clue to the soul of his sitter. Admiral Ludlow in James's picture had a stern eye with a hint of eager avarice. Yet there was a warmth there, plus a feeling of pride easily dented. It was very much the man his eldest son remembered. The flag hurt, for Harry knew that he would never follow in his father's footsteps, never hoist his own pennant above a king's ship. Tight, with that liberality that only an old retainer can muster, fussed round them, brushing cloth and adjusting coats, until finally, with a sharp and approving nod, he pronounced them fit to be seen in decent company.